Good morning, children. Once again, welcome back to the chemistry online class. Hope all are fine and safe at home. In the last class, we were discussing about changes around us. We learned some of the changes, that is slow and fast changes, reversible and irreversible changes. Today, we are going to learn another types of changes, that is physical and chemical changes and changes due to heat. First, let us learn about physical and chemical changes.
So, what is physical change? Changes in which physical properties of a substance undergo any changes are called physical changes. What are the physical properties? In a physical change, properties such as size, shape, and state of the substances changes, but no new substance is formed. For example, if we cut a paper into bits, the bits would still be of paper. And most of the physical changes are reversible changes. For example, melting of ice. Melting of ice is a physical change as well as a reversible change. Some examples of physical changes are melting of ice, stretching of a rubber band, folding a cloth, inflation of tires, cutting of a tree, etc. Moving on to chemical change. Changes in which chemical composition of a substance is changed are called chemical changes. In a chemical change, the original substance changes into a new substance which cannot be recovered. For example, if we burn a paper, it will turn into ashes, which is altogether a different substance. And chemical changes are irreversible changes. Some of the examples of chemical changes are milk into curd, cooking of egg omelette, digestion of food, rusting of iron, burning of paper, etc.
Moving on to changes due to heat. There are some changes that are caused due to heat. They are changes in state and changes in shape or size. We can learn more about changes due to heat with some examples.
Next change is changes due to heating. The changes caused due to heating involves change in state and change in shape or size. For example, have you ever wondered how the iron blade in tools used for digging soil is fixed to the wooden handle? To fix the handle, the ring is heated and it becomes slightly larger in size. That means it expands. Now the handle easily fits into the ring. When the ring cools down, it contracts and fits tightly onto the handle. Consider another example. How we can fit a rim on a wooden wheel of a cart? On heating, the rim expands and fits onto the wheel. Cold water is then poured over the rim, which contracts and fits tightly on the wheel. So, what can we conclude from these examples? Most substances, especially metals, expand on heating and contract on cooling. We can do more examples for changes due to heat. Children, you can see that metal wires which are used to hang wet clothes usually bend or sag due to increase in length in summer. This shows that metal expands on heating or due to increase in temperature. Let's see another example. Road materials like concrete have a tendency to expand on heating. Therefore, gaps are left between blocks of concrete on a bridge, as gaps provide space for the expansion. This helps to prevent any damage. Children, you might have seen that railway tracks are laid with small gaps in between. Why? Because the gap provides space to the railway tracks to expand when temperature increases in summer, and thus helps to prevent any accident. Now, let's see an example for changes in shape due to heat. You might have seen that when we add hot water to a plastic bottle, the shape of the bottle is changed. Now, changes in state due to heating. You know that when water boils, water changes to vapor on heating. This process is called evaporation. And vapor changes to water on cooling. This process is called condensation. You already learned in last chapter. Now we can convert water into ice by cooling the liquid up to its freezing point. This is an example for change in state due to heating.
Children, in every change that occurs around us, energy is evolved. This energy may be heat energy, light energy, sound energy, etc. Energy is either absorbed or produced during every change.
Energy is involved in every change that occurs around us. When we boil something, heat energy is evolved. When we light a candle, both light and heat energy is involved. This means that energy is either absorbed or produced during every changes.
So children, with this our chapter was completed. It is quite an easy chapter. In this chapter, we learned about some changes. We learned slow and fast changes, reversible and irreversible changes, physical and chemical changes, and changes due to heat. I hope all of you understood this lesson. I have attached a corresponding video URL, test questions and notes. Copy the notes and download the textual exercise questions that I have attached to this video. See you in the next class. Thank you, children.